All right, so today we are at Teotihuacan. I'm so bad at all the pronunciation here. It's about an hour north of Mexico City, and it's extremely impressive. Apparently, it is, they don't really know who built it. It wasn't the Aztecs. Tomas just told me this. It was built roughly 2,000 years ago, they estimate. At the time, it was the biggest and most important city in the Americas. They estimate the population around 125,000, possibly up to 200,000. Again, they don't really know anything, kind of guessing. And then apparently after about 600 years or so, the Aztecs took it over and sort of reclaimed it. It changed from the Temple of the Rain to the Temple of the Sun and the Temple of Fire. But let's go find out some more. Wow. It's just incredible that 2,000 years later, it's still standing. I don't even know really who built it. You can see some of the stuff on the outside is degraded a little bit and eroded. Wonder what it looked like before. It's absolutely incredible. We can't build a building that lasts for more than 100 years anymore. A cool place. The ruins of a whole city. It's incredible. Didn't realize how big this is. It's just a huge complex. Apparently it's about 25 square kilometers, and it really makes you wonder what life would have been like here back then. Check this out. Yeah, so before coming here, I definitely thought that this was all Aztec stuff, but yeah, it was people before the Aztecs, and they named them, I think, Teotihuacan. They don't really know. And then after it was built around 2,000 years ago, about 600 years after, there was a collapse of the civilization. They think it was infighting between the houses. There doesn't seem to be a centralization of power. They haven't found any carvings of like emperors or anything like that, so they think it was different families shared the power. There was infighting in those families, and that caused the collapse around 600 years AD. And after that, the Aztecs came and sort of, say, repurposed it. Apparently they didn't do too much to change anything, but the Aztecs took it over. This is all sort of administrative areas, and there's other parts, hopefully we'll see which is the residential areas. Maybe that's modern then. This is some kind of palace. I'm not sure what sort of palace it is, but some kind of palace we're going to go check out here. Hurt, yeah?
He's gonna hurt later.
The Temple of the Feathered Serpent, Quetzalcoatl.
warm.
Okay, so we had a great day at Teotihuacan, the old ruins, and we had some food and we're trying to get back. And we walked down this little path here that you can see, and we got to the other end of the path and the gate was closed. They'd locked the gate. I guess it's getting time to close. So we debated hopping over it, and some locals stopped and told us, no, don't hop over it, you shouldn't do that. Go to the other end of the gate. But you gotta get there quick because the policeman who just locked that gate is coming around to lock this gate. And turns out we're now locked in this little pathway outside of the pyramids. Alright, so someone apparently is coming to rescue us. Oh, here we go. Good. We're gonna get... You wonder why they didn't lock the one and then walk all the way through to make sure no one was here, but that's Mexico, I guess. Gracias. Alright, well, that was quite an exciting day, seeing the pyramids at Teotihuacan. Really impressive. What a huge complex. I didn't realize it was that big. Big, impressive, really cool, really old. About 2,000 years. If you see right behind me there, I'm pretty sure someone was murdered there last night. I'm just about two blocks away from where I'm staying, right in the middle of Mexico City. When I came to get the bike this morning, that cop car was there, and they had the yellow police tape around there. There wasn't that sheet like there was. When I came, Mexico, the downtown's actually really clean. They sweep it and brush it with water and everything every day. All the rest of the streets were clean, but inside that yellow police tape looked like last night. There was just, you know, the random debris, cigarette butts and whatever else, but there was also a blood stain, like a bloody sponge, some needle packages and what looked like medical gloves. So I'm assuming someone was either shot or stabbed or whatever there last night, and they're doing an investigation, because that was over 12 hours ago that I saw that. So that's interesting. I haven't felt unsafe in Mexico. I've tried to keep my wits about me, but actually I have felt unsafe, but only on the roads. On the roads I feel quite unsafe. Coming back, I hope some of the camera lasted with the battery, but you have to lane split. Without lane splitting, it's impossible to get anywhere. You'd just be sitting in traffic for hours and hours and hours. So that's interesting. That finishes my little journey today. I think tomorrow I'm gonna try and see the market, maybe, if that's open. The museum isn't open, I have to do that the next day, and then anyway, I'll check back in, see where we go.
There is mole.
Oh, my favorite.
Did you taste mole?
Yeah. Did you hear what kind they are? It's okay, don't worry, it's not your job. Alright, so we're going through the markets, and I think this is like elote, the corn stuff. Spicy with a bunch of mayo and cheese. It's delicious. Let's go find some weird food.
Alright, a bit of scorpion. Yeah, really just like French fried chicharrone.
Yeah.
Way better than you think it would be.
Yeah.
But then it's a bit chewy.
I would drink poke, which is some sort of stringy drink from agave. It's good. Thank you.
All right, that was Lucha Libre. Absolutely hilarious. Felt like a movie. Very Mexican experience. Absolutely hilarious.